Mr and Mrs Salisbury, You're a funeral parlour. This, if anything, was even worse than the workhouse.
Thank you. he had been hit many, many times, Oliver decided to retaliate when Noah insulted his mother by saying she was a bad woman. Oliver was punished by Mrs. Salisbury, who hit him again and locked him in a dark room for hours. Oliver could stand it no longer. As soon as he had the opportunity, he ran away. He made his way to London and had been walking for days with nothing to eat or drink except what he could beg, when he noticed that a rough-looking boy was standing close by, looking him up and down.
Hello, what are you doing here?
I'm hungry and tired and I've been walking for 7 days.
7 days? Don't worry, I'll help you find something to eat. Are you staying in London?
Yes, but I've nowhere to sleep and not a single farthing.
Don't worry, I know a nice subject who'll give you a bed for nothing.
Thanks. What's your name?
My name's Jack Dawkins, but they call me the Artful Dodger. What's yours?
Oliver Twist.
Okay then, let's start.
Well, what have you got for me today, boys?
Too bad, strong.
Very good at his job, isn't he, Oliver?
Yes, he is, sir.
And what have you got for me today, Charlie?
Some handkerchiefs.
Sir, well done, Charlie. Shall I show you how to take the marks out of the handkerchiefs and play this little game with them, Oliver?
Yes, please, sir.
Thank you.
Dangerous for a young lady like yourself.
What's wrong with a bit of danger? I like a bit of danger.
Young lady indeed. Sometimes I wish I really was a young lady. Have you seen the way them quality gentlemen treat their ladies?
Yes.
Shall we show them?
Go on, Nancy, give us a free show on the stage.
It's all bowing and hats are bowing.
Don't let your petticoats dangle in the mud, my dear. After you.
No, after you.
No, after you. Some fresh air and begged Fagin to let him go out with the Dodger and some of the other boys.
Please, sir, can I go out today?
Very well. Dodger Charlie, look after him and be back soon.
when Mr Brownlow asked that he should be treated kindly because he felt Oliver was innocent. Luckily, a witness turned up and complained that Oliver is not a thief. Oliver was thrown out of the courtroom and found by Mr Brownlow. Mr Brownlow took Oliver home with him, where he was looked after by Mrs Fagin, his housekeeper. Oliver gradually recovered. Mr Brownlow thought that Oliver reminded him of someone, and he realised that his features resembled those in the portrait of a young lady hanging over the fireplace.
That's the end of part one, and we shall now have a short intermission of about 5-10 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
boy. Fagin and Bill Sykes kept Oliver and tried to train him as a thief. During this time, he was rescued again by two rich ladies after a robbery which went wrong. Next, she managed to contact him as she feared for Oliver's life. At Fagin's house, she had overheard Oliver's half-brother, Monks, plotting to have him killed in order to get his hands on Oliver's fortune, for Oliver was really a rich man's son. The rich ladies, in turn, contacted Mr. Brownlow, Oliver's original benefactor. Mr. Brownlow couldn't wait to meet Nancy, but Nancy had a lot more to lose. She did not intend to betray Bill Sykes or Fagin, but she just had to help Oliver.
One consolation's
was his son. He took him to live in the country with the housekeeper, Mrs. Bedwin. Oliver was happy there, for he loved the fresh green countryside with its beautiful fields and flowers and trees. Once, Oliver had been a poor, misused orphan boy, whose only home was the workhouse. Now his future was bright, and life offered him much happiness. He had the inheritance his father had intended for him. Above all, now that Fagin was dead and his gang of thieves and killers had been broken up, Oliver need never be afraid of them again.
Very lucky to have a lot of extra help, unpaid it has to be said, from many ex-pupils, ex-parents and friends. So thank you very much. One thing I really shouldn't say because it's a bit political, but I think it has struck us, and certainly Rob Edmondson and I, that the money from your programme service is going to the Sunday Centre, a local charity for homeless people, down and out, drop-in parlour for lonely people as well. And I'm afraid it really has struck us, doing this production, that although Oliver was written over 100 years ago, it's really, unfortunately, not so very far away today.
Is Mrs. Pennell herself, including working extra hours, again unpaid. And just a little thank you, Mrs. Pennell.